According to Romans 10, verse 17, faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. The heard word of God, meditated upon and put into practice, engenders joy to the heart, thereby releasing your desired miracles. With an expectant and delightful heart, receive the anointed word of God from the throne of grace.
By the word of the Lord, every one oppression of the devil shall be terminated upon your life.
Get set for a journey into God's word that will enlighten you and give you an encounter to remember. And all who believe that shall be your experience, shout aloud, amen. Shout aloud, amen. Shout aloud, amen.
Show for this 3 days of waiting upon the Lord in prayer and fasting, lift up your two hands, lift up your voice, and shout the loudest glory. Father, thank you. You have gathered us for the blessing of the third day. In this breakthrough service, terminate breakdown in the life of everyone. Launch us into realms of breakthrough beyond our wildest imagination. The loudest amen, you have the largest package. Put your big hands together for the Lord and be seated. Praise God. It's my privilege tonight of God and his great servant here to stand before you and bring God's word in this breakthrough service and on this third day of our waiting upon the Lord in prayers and fasting. Every kind that must go in your life, in your family, tonight it shall disappear one by one. Everything due to you as a breakthrough, with the loudest amen tonight, you will hear good news. Our running theme for the month is, I am set for encounters with power. Let's declare together. I'm set. Encounters with power. All kind of encounters are packaged for you in this school of power this month. Tonight, the one due to you on the third day will arrive for you. I've been looking from the beginning of the month in our midweek services on understanding the person and the mission of the Holy Spirit. Understand the person and the mission of the Holy Spirit. And I'm taking part 1C of that message. And we know from scriptures, people of God, that the Holy Spirit is not a thing. He is a person. It's not a something somewhere. It's not an object somewhere. The Holy Spirit is a person. It's a personality. In John 14:26 from scripture, John 14:26, the word is clear. It said, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you, not it. He shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatever I have said unto you. He's a person. You can encounter him. He can touch you. He can reach you. He can help you. John 16:13, confirming again. John 16:13, talking about the person of the Holy Ghost. So, howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. He shall not speak unto himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak. And he will show you things to come. He's a person. He's the third person of the Trinity. God the Father, God the Son, and what? God the Holy Spirit. He's the third person of the Godhead. He's the chief executive of the Godhead. Is the one at work on the earth today. And that's why we've been studying also at his mission. He's sent on a mission on the earth for your transformation. He's sent on the mission on the earth for your redemption. He's sent on a mission on the earth for your liberation. He's sent on a mission on the earth for your restoration. He shall come. He shall teach you. He shall help you. He shall deliver you. And that's why step by step all through in our midweek services, we've been looking at him in action. so we can know how important it is for us to encounter him, particularly in the baptism of the Holy Ghost with evidence of speaking in tongues. Bible tells us, even the word of God, you need him. John 6:63, talking about him, it said, the words I speak to you, they are spirit and they are life. They are enlivened by the Holy Ghost himself. You need him. So we need to know how important he is in our lives so we can demand to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And God's servant will be here shortly and manifest again and minister to us. And everyone shall go back home filled afresh. Can I hear your amen? Luke chapter 11, verse 13. Luke 11, verse 13. He said, if you then, being evil, know how to give gifts, good gifts to your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask him? So he's saying that tonight is just by your asking. Very simple. There's a release by our asking, by our demand. There's a flow. And whatsoever things you ask in prayer, Matthew 21, 22, whatever things you ask in prayer, believe that you receive it. So I'd like us to get ready. He will minister. He'll administer. Believe that you receive. And then there shall be evidence tonight with speaking in tongues. Everybody shall go back home filled. If you expect, and let your amen be the loudest one. The person and the mission of the Holy Spirit. And we're looking at three of them quickly tonight. The first one, mission of the Holy Spirit to you and me, is that he is the Lord of the harvest. He is the Lord of the harvest. We prayed a moment ago. He is the one that takes charge on our harvest field for the drafting in of the multitudes. We're going out again tomorrow in our district outreaches all across our harvest field. The Holy Ghost is the one that takes charge of the harvest. Bible tells us multitude are in the valley of decision. But Jesus said, Matthew 9:38, pray ye therefore to the Lord of the harvest. He's the owner of the harvest. He's charge of the harvest. That he will send forth laborers into the harvest. That means that he will place laborers in the harvest field and empower them to perform. Matthew 9:38. Somebody is going to be on the harvest field tomorrow. And there shall be a Holy Ghost eruption in your life. The Holy Ghost will turn you to a wonder on the harvest field. I'm not hearing your amen. Somebody said he went out to the harvest and he told the Lord, he said, God, I want 50 souls today. Somebody said, I want you to give me 100 souls to bring on Sunday. And with the Holy Ghost as the Lord of the harvest, walking in you, walking through you, you will look for one. As you are talking to one, 10 will gather unto you. I said it a louder amen if you're there. He's the Lord of the harvest, making you dynamic on the harvest field, making you impactful on the harvest field, making you transformed on the harvest field, becoming wonder on the harvest field. Your language tomorrow will surprise you. I'm not hearing an amen from somebody. The impact of your ministry tonight, tomorrow shall be a wonder to you. And come Sunday morning, the largest harvest we have ever seen. If you believe with me that we're going to get them in Goshen on Sunday, let that amen be the loudest one. Let me see at this point, brethren, that God is committed to you to the extent to which you are committed to his agenda. God is committed to you to the extent to which you are committed to serve him, committed to go forth to the harvest field. Go ye out, Luke 14:21-23, to the highways, to the byways, and gather them to come. Luke 14:21-23. Once you are committed to go on the go, the Lord of the harvest will help you. Every time you are committed to serve the Lord, to pursue his interests, God arise on your behalf. In Exodus 4:23, Exodus 4:23, concerning the people of Israel, he said to Moses, he said to tell Pharaoh, let my son go, that he may serve me on the field. If you refuse to let him go, he said, I will slay your son. That means once you are consciously on the go for God, on the field for the Lord, He can manifest anyway for you. Get committed for him. Get on the go for him. Jesus said, I'm among you as one that serveth. Follow my example. Let's go bring them in. Luke 22, verse 27. I'm among you as one that serveth. Be on the go. Let's go together. Let's serve together. Let's bring them in together. And God will surprise you this month of August. Say loud amen. In Luke chapter 10, for emphasis, verse 1 and 2. Luke 10, 1 and 2. Bible tells us, he sent them forth, two by two, to go to the city. And sent them to go and manifest, bring them in. And in verse 2, the Bible tells us that he said to them, the harvest truly is great. The laborers are few. Pray ye to the Lord of the harvest, the Holy Ghost, to send for laborers into the vineyard. That means as we go, Jesus said, pray. The Lord of the harvest will empower everyone on the field for unusual manifestation. Empower everyone on the field. It will empower your tongue. Touch your tongue with the coals of fire. He clothes you with his glory. He strengthens you. He'll energize you. Make your word. He said that the Lord was walking with them, confirming their word with signs following. Mark 16, verse 20. He's the Lord of the harvest to help you on the field, to confirm your word as sent by the Lord, to energize you on the field, to make sure that your going tomorrow shall not be in vain. Everyone on the go, God shall answer to you. In Romans chapter 1 verse 16, Romans 1 verse 16, talking about empowerment by the Lord of harvest. He said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It's the power of God to salvation. So as I am on the go manifesting, power comes down by the Holy Ghost. They went. The Lord of the harvest went with them. And so much empowered them that they came to a point, they said, I see Satan fall down like lightning. Satan will fall for you tomorrow. Shout a louder amen if you're there. In Luke chapter 10, verse 17 to 19, pray to the Lord of the harvest. Let him go with us. He said, they return to return. I said, Lord, all the devils were brought down. Why? The Lord of the harvest went with us. He's going with us tomorrow. He said, I beheld Satan fall down like lightning. Somebody with a loud amen, that shall be your testimony tomorrow. And then he empowered them again. Verse 19. He empowered them again. He said, power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. And about the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by enemies hurt you. Friends, as we undergo, the Lord of the harvest will go with us. Whatever wants to hurt you, tonight, that arrow is returned to the sender. He is the Lord of the harvest, our helper on the field, our strengthener on the field, our comforter on the field, drawing in the harvest, bringing them in, drafting them in, setting them in Zion. And once you go on that level of commitment, hear that testimony. Say Matthew 6:33 is truly a reality. Dr. David Oyedepo is a prophet of God. Because when he went, the Holy Ghost went with him, empowered him, enabled him, and came back with a testimony, a kind of breakthrough that can only be look at it and be speaking in tongues. Somebody that you are the next one for that kind of testimony. I thought that amen would be a louder word. Number two is that the Holy Ghost, he convicts men of sin, of righteousness, and of judgment. We need him. We need his baptism. We need his presence. We need his fullness. Because once he's at work in us and through us, he will help to address the sin factor in our lives and around our lives. The Holy Ghost, he helps to address and arrest the sin factor in our lives and around our lives. He convicts men. He checks men of sin. No, not anymore. That's no longer your portion. In John 16, we read a part earlier. He said, now verse 7, nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It's expedient that I go away. If I go not away, the comforter, the helper will not come. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. And when he's come, He will reprove the world of sin so that he can improve your life. Reprove the world of sin so it can enhance your destiny of righteousness, of judgment, of sin because they believe on me, of righteousness because I go to the Father, and you see me no more, of judgment because the prince of this world is judged. Somebody that you are confident that there is judgment on your behalf, shout aloud, amen. The prince of the world, this world, is arrested. He goes with us. He answers to us and begin to pick out sin and unrighteousness. I say, not anymore. Clear the sin factor. Judge the sin factor. Frustrate the sin factor. I'd like you to know Proverbs 14 verse 34. Proverbs 14 verse 34, the sin factor. It said, righteousness exalts a nation. But sin is a reproach to any people. It's an attack on man's destiny. It's a destroyer of man's destiny. It's a killer of man's destiny. And the Holy Spirit is sent to take care of this evil cancer around our lives. This wickedness around our lives. Around the lives of your converts. Around the lives of our new members. Our new converts. Our old members. Men on the altar. You and I. In the book of Romans, the writer painted a very interesting picture about why we need to address this sin factor. Read a few lines of scripture in Romans chapter 7, verse 17, all the way down through the 24. Very interesting one. He said, now then, it is no more I that doeth it, but sin that dwells in me. But you are going free tonight. He said, for I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. For to will is present with me. But how to perform it, the good thing, that's my challenge. The more I try, I get frustrated. To do good things, the more I try, I get messed up. But with the loud amen, somebody's going free from sin tonight. Verse 19, he said, there's that evil with me. He said, for the good that I would do, I do not. The evil that I would not, that's what I keep doing. The sin factor. What I don't want to do, I keep myself doing it. The one I want to do, I can't do it. Verse 20. He says, now if I do that with not, it's no more I that do it. It's still sin that is troubling me. Sin that dwelleth in me. That factor must be addressed. Verse 21. He said, but if I then the law that when I do good, evil is present with me. I want to do good. Evil is there. I want to do good. Evil is there. But you must go free tonight. I say you must go free tonight. I say you must go free tonight. Everyone you reach out to tomorrow, the sin factor, by the help of the Holy Ghost, shall be addressed in the name of Jesus. I'm not hearing a louder amen. Verse 23 and 24, talking about this sin factor, must be addressed. He said, I see another law in my members, warring against the law in my mind, bringing me into captivity to the law of sin, which is in my members. Verse 24, he said, oh, wretched man I am. Maybe somebody's saying that. Who can deliver me from this body of death, from this sin factor? Good news. Tonight, the Holy Ghost will deliver you. I expected a louder amen from somebody that wants deliverance. You see, I've become a wretched man in the family, still smoking and coming to church, still drinking and coming to church, still masturbating and coming. Who will deliver me from this evil thing? But Jesus said, I will send you the comforter, send you the helper. Because even Jesus had to be helped from this sin factor with power by the Spirit of Holiness. Romans 1:4. Jesus had to be delivered, had to be helped, had to be secured by power. Romans 1:4. He said, and declared to be the Son of God with power according to the Spirit of Holiness and the resurrection of the dead. So when the Holy Ghost comes, he will empower you to live a holy life. Shout amen. Baptized with the Spirit of Holiness and clear all the debris and say, this is mine, touch him not. This is mine, touch him not. This is mine, touch him not. Everything that looks like sin in your life, or righteousness in your life, evil in your life, making a mockery of your Christianity, with the loudest amen, be free tonight. And the Holy Ghost does it violently when you let him. In Isaiah chapter 4, verse 4, when you let him, he comes and clears it. He said, when the Lord shall have washed away the filth of the daughters of Zion, and shall have purged the blood of Jerusalem from the midst thereof by the spirit of judgment, and by what? The spirit of burnings. So he appears as smoking fire to consume the debris. The Lord was determined to purge. The Lord is determined to clear. Let him. The Lord is determined to, and the Holy Ghost will come with the spirit of judgment and of burning to burn off every mark of masturbation in your life. Burn up every mark of smoking in your life. Burn up every mockery of Christianity tonight. Burn off every evil in your life. Tonight, by the Holy Ghost fire, it is consumed in the name of Jesus. In Matthew 3, 11 and 12, he said he will come as a purifier, as a cleanser, where you are baptized with the Holy Ghost. And with fire tonight, it will sit upon your life. And verse 12, what where you said his fire is in his hand, he will thoroughly purge his floor, purge your life, purge your destiny. And as you go out tomorrow, you let him loose, he'll do the same job. Gather the weeds in Ghana. He will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. I know you are here. It was sin that made you lose your marriage the last time. It was sin that made you lose your job the last time. It was sin that brought that HIV, brought that sickness, brought that attack. But tonight, you have come to Jesus in repentance. You have come to Jesus, the liberator. By your encounter with the Holy Ghost tonight, Holy Ghost fire, that evil mark is consumed. I'm not hearing an amen from somebody. He'll empower you to live a holy life. Empower you to be distinguished among men. Empower you to glorify God. You are bought with a price. You must therefore glorify God in your spirit and in your body. You are bought with a price. 1 Corinthians 6:20. You are bought with a price. All those souls out there purchased by his blood. We must therefore glorify God in our body, in our spirit. They all belong to God. Whatever is making a mockery in your life, reject it with the loudest amen. Number three, mission of the Holy Spirit. Oh, very interesting. It says the fire of the Holy Ghost will help us to stay awake spiritually. The Holy Ghost fire will help us to stay awake spiritually. Our Father in the faith, yeah, will always say, when you stay awake spiritually, Satan will stay away from your life. When you stay awake spiritually, Satan will stay away from your family. Stay away from the works of your hands. And God is saying, the Holy Ghost is let loose in our lives to keep us awake. Keep us vigilant. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 9. Be sober, be vigilant. The adversary, the devil, whom you resist steadfastly, 8 and 9. Resist him by faith. Be sober, be vigilant. He's looking for whom he may devour. Come awake. He wants to mess up another person. Block your harvest. Frustrate your harvest. Mess up the seeds you have sown. So we need to come awake. Come alive. In Jeremiah 20 verse 9, he said, then I said, I will no longer make mention of him. I'm not going for outreach again. I won't speak in his name anymore. I'm tired. We have been praying. What are we going for outreach again tomorrow for? He said, but his word was in my heart as a burning fire up in my bones. But I was weary with forbearing, and I could not stay. I had to go again. Hallelujah. Whatever is trying to make a mockery of you, to block you, make you weak, make you weary, you are going free from it tonight. Satan wants to tie you down. In fact, brethren, the greatest enemy of a high-level spirituality is the spirit of slumber. The spirit of lethargy, slumber, slipping away, refusing to be vigilant. Spirit of slumber. is the enemy of spirituality. Makes you weak, makes you weary. He said, the spirit is willing, but my flesh is weak. It's the spirit of slumber. Matthew 26, verse 41. The spirit of slumber. Come awake. Otherwise, Satan will mess you up. Ephesians 5:14. Ephesians 5:14. Bible says, awake thou that sleepest. That sleep is your enemy. It doesn't really matter. I will go next week. It doesn't really matter. Awake thou that sleepest. Arise from the dead, and Christ will give thee light. Amen. That darkness in your life is there because you are sleeping away. The job is also sleeping away. Once you go to sleep, the breakthrough will slip away. Once you go to slumber, the slave will slip away. But God is saying, come alive. Come awake. Stay awake. Jesus was praying, and the men with him were sleeping. And when they woke up, they saw his glory. They had lost it. Each time you allow the sleep of slumber to get the best of you, something is lost in your life. Something is messed up in your life. Something is missing in your life. In Luke chapter 9, verse 28, 29, Luke 9, 28 and 29, Jesus went to the mountain to pray. And he prayed. He said, 8 days, he went to the mountain, took Peter and John and James, three powerful men, to go pray with him. And verse 29, Bible says he was praying with so much intensity, with so much strength, and his countenance was altered. His raiment was as white and glistering. That means in prayer, there's transformation going on. From shame to glory, from weakness to strength, from curses to blessing. That was Jesus. And while he was praying and traveling, others were sleeping. Verse 32, Bible says, verse 32, and when they woke up, he said, but Peter and they that were with him were heavy with sleep. That's the enemy of spirituality. And when they awake, they saw his glory, and two men stood with him. Tonight, I declare in your life, that spirit of slumber, that spirit of lethargy, is cursed in the name of Jesus. It's cursed in the name of Jesus. It's your year of glory to glory. That spirit of slumber will deprive you of glory. That spirit of slumber will deprive you of glory. Lift your hands, I prophesy. In every way, every spirit of slumber is tortured in your life. Be free in the name of Jesus. Be delivered in the name of Jesus. God is saying, stay awake and stay on fire spiritually. The fire on your altar must never go out. And when that happens, once your altar is always on fire, your breakthrough is on the way. Your harvest will remain. What God has given to you, none shall be lost. I'm not hearing you, amen. Say, hear me, brethren. Every testimony of manifestation, of glorification, is because there's continuous fire on the altar. Leviticus chapter 6, verse 12 and 13. 12 and 13. The wood, there shall always be wood burning on your altar to keep the fire on, spirituality on. Staying in the word, staying in prayer, staying in fastings, and the Holy Ghost will set your altar on fire. Verse 13. Then he said, and the fire upon your altar shall be burning. It will never go out. Tonight, everyone that believes, by the ministration of the Holy Ghost, you are coming under fresh fire. Your altar shall come under fresh fire. I am not hearing your aim. Every revival, every awakening, every transformation is a product of fire. The Holy Ghost are fresh. We have read about the Azusa Street revival. We had almost the whole of nations were set on fire from one location. The testimony has it that one man was on his knees. They called his name William Simon. And that man would pray 5 hours every day for 2.5 years. 5 hours every day for 2.5 years. On fire. Spiritually on fire. In fastings and prayers. Lord, set our nation on fire. Lord, deliver the captives. Lord, set them free. And in the midst of that fire, one day fire like Pentecost came down from heaven. They were there for 120 days and then praying, and suddenly the heavens opened. Fire came down from heaven and everywhere was set on fire. What eyes have not seen, what ears have not heard, began to happen on the earth by this revival. Make sure you are fully there. We read tonight, a man will say for 5 hours he was in prayer during the day and 2 hours again in the night, and suddenly everything erupted. After tonight's own power will come upon you from on high. Holy Ghost fire will come upon you from on high. You'll be on fire to stay spiritual. You'll be on fire to stay dynamic. You'll be on fire to get result on the prayer altar. The loudest amen, receive it. A man of God, they called his name Alexander Dowie. Pastored a church. And everybody was dying one by one of all kinds of evil sicknesses and all kinds of calamities. And the testimony had it that this man, he came alive spiritually one day and said, no, enough is enough. Tonight, somebody's going to react. Tonight, somebody's going to react. Tonight, somebody's going to react. He said, no, not anymore. He entered into prayers with fasting. God, there must be a way out. Deliver us. Enough. And suddenly, he took his Bible opening, and the Bible just opened one day to Acts chapter 10, verse 38. How God anointed Jesus with the Holy Ghost and with power. He went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. And from there, everywhere caught fire. From that one scripture, he thundered against that deadly disease. Everybody was healed, liberated, and the plague returned to the sender. And that church was delivered finally. Friends, tonight, as you come under this Holy Ghost fire, everyone tormented in your family shall be delivered. Everything molesting your job shall be delivered. All that have vowed that you will not see glory this year shall be subdued one by one. Somebody ready for a new fire? Lift up your voice and shout the loudest. Amen. Put your big hands together for the Lord. You are going free tonight. My friends, you have come before the one that will never tell you go back. The one that will never tell you come back tomorrow. Today is your day of salvation. Today is your day of liberty. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor. You have suffered enough. You have struggled enough. And I will give you rest. That tonight, God will turn your darkness to light. God will turn your failure to success. He will turn your poverty to prosperity. But he says, if you are not born again, you cannot reign with him. If you are not born again, you cannot be blessed by him. If you are not born of God, you cannot be changed by him. Wherever you are, you want to become a child of God, be free from all the attacks of hell. You want to become born again, free from sin, liberated by God. Rise to your feet. I want to pray with you. Your night is your night. Wherever you are, God bless you. Rise to your feet. Tonight is your night. I want to surrender to Jesus. I want to be free from sin. Rise to your feet. God bless you wherever you are. Enough is enough. Rise to your feet. Tonight is your night of liberty. Pick your bag and Bible and just come to the front here. I want to pray with you. You want to surrender your life? Enough is enough. I want to be free. Pick your bag and Bible and just come to the front here. The more you clap, the faster they come. You are under the sound of my voice. You have been crying for a day of deliverance. When will I be delivered from this captivity? When will I be delivered from this shame? When will I be delivered from this continuous attack? Rise to your feet, run to Jesus. Tonight is your night of deliverance. Rise to your feet, run to Jesus. Tonight is your night of deliverance. Rise to your feet and just keep coming. Enough is enough. Waiting is wasting. You have been waiting for your miracle for long. But he said, don't wait anymore. Rise to your feet and walk out your own salvation with fear and trembling. All those that have been waiting and waiting for deliverance to come, waiting and waiting for salvation to come, run to Jesus tonight. It's your night of encounter. Run to Jesus tonight. It's your night of encounter. No waiting anymore. Waiting is wasting without knowing. You have been waiting for help. Help has come. Rush to the front here. The more you clap, the faster they come. You're seated there and you're wondering, when will it be your turn? Tonight is your turn. Well, somebody else's turn the last time. Jesus says, everything about the Lord that I change not, but I change things. Let him change your name, change your story. Let him repair your destiny. Enough is enough. Rise to your feet and join them quickly. You want to rededicate your life to the Lord so he can restore for you. You want to rededicate your life to God so he can restore for you. You're still seated there. All you have lost can be recovered now. Jesus came. The devil came to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But Jesus came that you may have life and have it more abundantly. You want to have your life restored, your glory restored, your beauty restored? Quickly, rise to your feet and join them. Quickly, rise to your feet and join them. I want to have a restoration of all that I have lost. Only Jesus can give you back restoration. Join them quickly. I want to see restore. Bring back what you have lost. Bring back what the devil has taken from you. Rush quickly. Rush quickly. Run, run, run. There's fire on the mountain. Rush quickly. There's fire on the mountain. Don't say the other man's turn. It is your turn. You are born again before. You lost your salvation. Take it back now. Run to Jesus. Take it back now. Run to Jesus. The joy of salvation is available now. Some more. Come on, your hands as they come. All those in front, lift up your right hand and say this prayer after me. Say it very loud. Say, Lord Jesus. Say louder, Lord Jesus, I come to you tonight to surrender my life. Save me. Make me your own child. From tonight, I decide and I declare, Jesus is my Lord. Jesus is my Savior. Thank you, Lord. I am born again. I'm free from sin. I'm a child of God. In Jesus' mighty name. Say loud amen. I pray for you that from tonight, the evil you saw before you came here, you said no more again forever. You are blessed. Open your eyes and say thank you, Jesus. Turn around, please. Follow these officials and they will attend to you. God bless you. Church, rise to your feet. Somebody ready for baptism, ready for an encounter, ready for fire. Lift your voice and shout aloud, glory.